Quadratic Equations, Factoring, Level 2. In the previous video, we introduced a general procedure to solve quadratic equations by factoring. As a refresher, we will review the procedure. It consisted of three steps. The first step was to write the quadratic equation with 0 on one side. The second step was to factor the other side of the equation. And the final step was to solve the equation by setting each linear factor equal to 0. Recall that in the previous video, we practiced step 3. Specifically, using the zero product property to find the zeros or roots of the quadratic equation. Applying this last step is actually pretty easy, granted that we are able to factor the quadratic equation into linear factors. So how exactly do we factor a quadratic equation? Well, it depends on the type of quadratic equation you're faced with. In general, there are two types of quadratic equations that can be solved by factoring. They include quadratic binomials of the form ax squared plus bx equals 0, and quadratic trinomials of the form ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. Let's first go over quadratic binomials of the form ax squared plus bx equals 0. Quadratic equations of this form are pretty much guaranteed to be solvable by factoring. This is because a quadratic binomial of this form always contains a variable as a greatest common factor, also known as a GCF, and therefore can be factored out every single time. Once we have it in factored form, we go ahead and apply the zero product property. Notice that we will always obtain x equals 0 as one solution when dealing with quadratic binomials of the form ax squared plus bx equals 0. The second solution will be an expression in terms of the coefficients a and b. Alright, let's go ahead and try some examples. Solve the equation x squared plus x equals 0. First, notice that we are dealing with a quadratic equation, because the highest power out of all the terms is 2. In other words, we are dealing with a polynomial of degree 2. In addition, notice that it's a quadratic binomial of the form ax squared plus bx equals 0, where both a and b are equal to 1. Keep in mind that quadratic equations of this form can always be solved by factoring. So we go ahead and solve this equation by using this technique. The first step is to make sure that we have 0 on one side of the equation. We see that this is the case. It has been taken care of. So the first step is done. The second step is to factor the quadratic equation. We do this by noticing that each term on the left-hand side contains the variable x as its GCF, or greatest common factor. So we go ahead and factor that out and multiply it by what is left after factoring. In this case, we leave behind the quantity x plus 1. So now we have the expression x times the quantity x plus 1 equals 0. It's always a good idea to check and make sure you factored the quadratic equation correctly by distributing the factor and making sure you obtain the original quadratic equation. Doing that, we see that we indeed factored the expression the correct way. By factoring the quadratic equation, we have successfully completed step 2. Now the last step is to apply the zero product property and set each factor equal to 0. Recall that in the previous video, we went over various examples in carrying out this last step. So at this point, completing this step should be more or less second nature for you. So we go ahead and set each factor equal to 0. The first factor is automatically equal to 0. Setting the second factor equal to 0 and solving for x, by subtracting 1 from both sides, we obtain the second solution, x is equal to negative 1. If we were to graph the left-hand side of the equation, we would obtain the following graph. Notice that this graph crosses the x-axis at 0, 0 and negative 1, 0. These are the roots or zeros of the quadratic equation. I want you to notice that when you solve quadratic equations of the form ax squared plus bx equals 0, you always obtain x equals 0 as one solution, because this particular type of quadratic binomial always contains a single variable as a GCF, which can be factored out every single time. Alright, let's go ahead and try the next example. Solve the equation x squared minus 5x equals 0. Notice that we are dealing with a quadratic binomial for which both terms contain a single variable in common. Before we factor anything out, we need to make sure that one side is set to 0. For this particular problem, this has already been done for us, so step 1 is complete. Second step is to factor the quadratic equation, so we do this by noticing that each term contains a single variable in common. In other words, its GCF, greatest common factor, is x. So we go ahead and factor this expression out, and we are left with the quantity x minus 5. Having factored the quadratic equation, we go ahead and apply the zero product property to each of the two factors. Once again, notice that one solution is equal to 0. And for the second solution, we go ahead and solve the equation x minus 5 equals 0. So we do this by adding 5 to both sides of the equation and obtain x equals 5 as the second solution. All right, let's try the last example. Solve the equation 3x squared plus 2x equals 0. Once again, we are dealing with a quadratic binomial. So we first need to set one side equal to 0. And this has been taken care of for us. Next, we go ahead and factor the quadratic equation. Notice that both terms have a single variable in common. So we go ahead and factor that out. Doing that, we obtain x times the quantity 3x plus 2 equals 0. Always check to make sure you factor the expression correctly by mentally distributing what you initially factored out, and making sure you obtain the original quadratic equation. Having successfully factored out the quadratic equation, we go ahead and solve for x by applying the zero product property. So we set each factor equal to 0. Doing that, we obtain x equals 0 as one solution. The second solution is obtained by solving the equation 3x plus 2 equals 0. So we first subtract 2 from both sides of the equation and obtain the following expression. Next, we divide both sides by 3 and simplify. Doing that, we obtain x equals negative 2/3 as the second solution. Notice again that we always obtain x equals 0 as one solution when dealing with these types of quadratic binomials. Alright, in our next video, we will continue solving quadratic binomials of the form ax squared plus bx equals 0 with slightly harder examples.